Okay, section 1.3. Actually, this is the first new concept that you're going to learn from this linear algebra class. Okay, equations of line and planes. Okay, you have the lecture note that I have already made on this website, and my earlier lectures on these sections in this YouTube web class. In this section, we will derive vector equations of lines and planes in R3, and we will examine shortest distance problems related to these equations. Shortest distance problems that you are familiar with from the SAT exams. Okay, point slope equation over line. Point slope equation. In R3, an equation of a line can be uniquely determined when a slope and the specified point on the line are given. What that means is, suppose in R3, suppose you have a line like this, L. If you have information that says it has a slope like this, and it passes through a certain point, then you can, it starts from a certain point and it has a direction like this, then you can always specify what is that vector, what is that line. Okay, so think about this. Suppose that if a line passes through a point P0, P0, and which is parallel to a vector V like this, and the vector can be written as a linear combination of this IJK, which is 1, 0, 0, 0, 1, 0, and 0, 0, 1. Those are standard unit vectors. There's a linear combination of standard unit vectors like this. Suppose, okay, then this vector, P from a vector from P0 to P, is parallel to V, clearly. Okay? That means the line is a set of all points that satisfy the following equations, a line passes through the point, which means this is a vector that we are looking for. This is the equation for the line, which is a parallel to this V vector, which comes from the given information. So the all lines can be written as this, isn't it? Scalar multiple of the vector which has the same direction. Only the distance is different. Okay? The distance is different. Okay. So with those concepts, suppose OP0 is a P0 vector. Suppose this is a P0 vector. And OP is a P vector, which is this arbitrarily point X, Y, Z in here. This is P0 and this is a P. Then P0, a vector from P0 to P is this, isn't it? This is a vector, which is on the line L. Okay? So this vector can be written as a P minus P naught. Then P minus P naught, P0, can be written as this is a parallel to V, isn't it? Parallel to V. But V has a distance, which is can be specified with the scalar T. So P minus P0 vector can be written as a scalar multiple of V, which is parallel to this line. So this can be written this way. So this P, which is a vector from 0 to X, 0, 0, 0 to X, Y, Z. This vector P can be written as a P0 plus TV. So this equation clearly explains the line with the vectors in a vector form. So we call this equation is called a vector equation. Vector equation means this vector, this line actually from P0 to P. This equation clearly explains this line start from P0 to P. that passes through the point P0 here. Okay, like this. So P is OP, P0 is OP0, P0 is, and the vector equation, the line, the part of line L, this red line, can be represented as a vector equation like this. And from here, we can go a little further. Parametric equation. In terms of coordinate, this can be written as what? X, Y, Z. X, Y, it is X, Y, Z is equal to X0, Y0, Z0 plus T times ABC, which can be written in this way. X is equal to X0 plus TA. Second component of this is this. And third component of this P, which is G, is this. So we call this is a parametric equation because we are using the parameter T. And also from here, T can be isolated by subtracting X naught and divided by A. So X minus X naught over A is T, and Y minus Y naught over B is T, and G minus G naught over T is C is equal to T. So they are all same as T, which has a kind of symmetry in it. So this also represents the same equation like this and same equation like this of lines. So we call this is a symmetric equation of a line. So if we are asked to find the vectors and the parametric and symmetric equations of a line of the line that passes through the point P, 2, minus 1, 3, and is parallel to the vector V, which is minus 3, 2, 4, then we can find a vector equation and parametric equation and symmetric equation. How? As you see here, the parametric the vector equation x y g, so p is equal to p naught, which is 2 minus 1 3 plus t times vector v, isn't it? This is the equation for the vector equation, and this is rewriting of the given vector equation, and this is can be written as this: x times linear combination of 1 0 0 plus y times 0 1 0 plus g times 0 0 1 is this, and which is same as this 2 a vector 2 minus 1 3 times t times vector v. So this is a p plus p 0 plus t v. This is a vector equation of this line. This can be written as x is equal to 2 minus 3t, y is equal to minus 1 plus 2t, g is equal to 3 plus 4t. If we write x, y, z in terms of t, then this forms a parametric equation of the line that we are looking for. And from here, if we subtract 2 and divide by minus 3, then this is same as t, which is t, which is same as y plus 1 over 2, which is same as g minus 3 over 4. Okay, this symmetric form, the equations of symmetric form, forms a symmetric equation of the line that we are looking for. So whatever we find one, then all the followings will be easily followed. Then this is the easiest way of finding the line. All we have to do is P is equal to the given point P naught plus scalar T times the direction, which is parallel. Okay. So whatever the given you can deal with the problems with these informations without difficulties. Find the parametric equations for the line that passes through the point P and Q. How you want to find it? Parametric equation that for the line that passes through these two points. All you have to do is find the vector with the direction, this V. To find the vector equation, we need what? A point and the direction, isn't it? The direction comes from these two points because it passes through those points. So if you subtract P from Q, PQ, the vector from P to Q, which is V, is what? 4 minus 1 minus 1, minus 1, 0, minus 2, 0, minus, minus 2, which is this. So we have a V, and we have a point. So we have a point, P naught, and we have a vector V. So vector equation is what? P is, vector P is equal to P0 plus vector P equal, yeah? Vector, yeah, here, P, vector equation, P is P0, which this P can be used, and the vector V was found in here, so the vector equation that we were looking for was this XYZ, this P is equal to P0 plus T times V, like this. Isn't it? So, from here, parametric equation can be found in what? X is equal to 1 plus 3t, y is equal to 1 minus 2t, and g is equal to minus 2 plus 2t. So the parametric equation that we are looking for is x is equal to 1 plus 3t, y is equal to 1 minus 2t, and g is equal to minus 2 plus 2t for a parameter t. So that can be found in this way. All we need is one point and a direction of the vector that represents the lines. Last part, point normalization of plane. Before we were considering a line. Now we think the equation, the plane, the vector equation for the plane in three-dimensional space. A plane in R3 can be uniquely obtained by specifying a point P0, and in the plane, and the non-zero vector N, which is called the normal vector, ABC, which is perpendicular to the plane. So this plane can be represented as with a point on the plane and a normal vector N, because every vector in this plane, so choose the arbitrary vector P, which is XYZ. Then if you draw, find the vector from P0 to P, which is XYZ, X minus X0, Y minus Y0, and G minus 0, then any vector on the plane is also normal to, orthogonal to this normal vector N, because this normal vector is orthogonal to the plane. So with those information, we have the equation that inner product of this normal vector and this or any vector on the plane, this should be zero because they are orthogonal. This comes from this n vector is ABC, and P a vector from P0 to P is can be written in this way. So inner product of this can be written in this way, isn't it? This can be simplified in this way: AX plus BY plus CG is equal to AX0 plus BY 0 plus CT 0, which we can write as a D. So this is a typical equation of the plane, which comes from a normal vector and any vector on the plane. So any plane can be written simply in this way with the vectors that we learned. Okay, then let's think about how the plane. Let's go a little further. How we can write the plane with the vector equation here. Suppose we have a plane W, then any vector on this plane, which is, let's say, the X is a vector from X0, then this vector can be written as a linear combination of two vectors, V1 and VT, isn't it? So a plane W in R3 can be uniquely obtained by passing through a point X0 and two non-zero vectors, V1 and V2 in R3, that are not scalar multiple of one another. If we have two vector V1 and V2, which is not a linear combination, not a scalar multiple of one another, then any vector can be written as a linear combination of these two. So like this, X minus X0, which is a vector, can be written as a linear combination of these two vectors. So X, which is represents for this point, is equal to X0 plus T1 V1 plus T2 V2. This is for the line equation, you had this. for the equation for the plane, you have two vectors instead of one. Okay? So any plane can be written in this way. This is called the vector equation for plane. And if we have this, this can be written simply in this way. Like x here, x is equal to the first component of x is the vector x is the what? X zero, x is equal to x zero plus t one a one plus t two a two. Y is equal to y zero plus b one t one plus b two t two. G is equal to g zero plus c one t one plus c two t two, like this. This is called the parametric equation of the plane. Then the example shows find the vector and parameter equation of the plane that passes through the 3 points. You have learned how to solve these problems in high school years, but the approach that are using now, that we are using now, is with the concept of the vectors in Rn. That's the only difference. Okay, so we are looking for an equation of the plane that passes through this 3 point. So from this information, we generate two vectors which are not a scalar multiple of the others. So just think about the PQ vector and what? PR vector. So PQ vector and PR vector. And then we can think of this. Then these two are clearly not a scalar multiple of the others. So any vector, x minus x naught, can be written as a linear combination of these two vectors, like this. Any vector, x minus x naught, is a linear combination of these two vectors. So the x, y, g can be written as this. Here, x0 can be any vectors, any point on this. So this forms a vector equation of the plane. So x, y, g can be written as what x naught is, let's say, this p as x naught, then x is equal to this point x naught plus t1 plus this v1 and v2 here. Plus t. So x, y, g can be written as 4 plus 2t1 minus 3t2, and g can be written as 1 plus 6t1 plus t2, like this. So x is equal to this, y is equal to this, and g is equal to this. This forms a parametric equation of the plane that we are looking for. Okay, and you can do the simulation of this in here. And this is a very interesting thing. Here, I gave you a 3 point. Then this gives us the equation of the plane. If we change the point differently, then this gives us another equation that passes through this 3 point. If we change this, then this is an equation of the plane that passes through this point. This comes from these algorithms, and this is a simulation of it. And that, okay. We learned how to find the equation of the plane with those vectors, and this is another approach that can be done by using the concept of determinant that you're going to learn. Okay, this is a simulation. And vector projection and component is the next. So I think time's up, so I will finish up the lecture of today here, and we will continue to explain the projection and the shortest distance problems in the second week lectures. Any questions?